Video number 44, part B, finding vertical and horizontal asymptotes. In the first one, we just went through the first page here, talking about as x approaches different values and what happens, what the definition of a vertical and horizontal asymptote is. So here we are. Find the vertical and horizontal asymptotes for f of x. Well, the vertical asymptotes, we look to see where the denominator is 0. Well, where is x squared minus 9, 0? At 3 and negative 3. Therefore, we have vertical asymptotes at x equals 3 and x equals negative 3, which are, of course, vertical lines. Horizontal asymptotes, we look to see what f of x will approach as x approaches infinity. So as x gets larger in f of x, the 4 and the 2x and the 9 become virtually insignificant. Just think about the number 10. If you plugged in 10 here, you're going to get something close to 2, because the 4 and the 2x aren't really going to bring this value of 200 down that much, and the 9's not really going to bring this 100 value if you use 10 here. So therefore, we would say f of x approaches 2. Therefore, horizontal asymptote is f of x equals 2, which of course is a horizontal line. Finding vertical and horizontal asymptotes for f of x here, let's take a look. Vertical asymptotes, we look to see where the denominator is 0. Well, x squared plus 4 equals 0. Well, that's not going to happen. X squared will not be a negative number for real numbers. Therefore, we would say f of x has no vertical asymptotes. And then horizontal, we look to see what f of x will approach as x gets larger. Well, here, the 4 and this minus 4 and plus 4 become insignificant, so we don't even worry about that. So actually, 3x minus 4 over x squared plus 4 approaches 3x over x squared. Well, as x is getting closer and closer to infinity, what's happening is the denominator is growing at a much larger rate because the degree is larger. Therefore, we would say f of x approaches 0. Therefore, we have a horizontal asymptote at f of x equals 0. Any questions or concerns, please send me an email, and of course, good times.